Hi friends, welcome to the cooking channel Kitchen to Kitchen. Today I'm going to share with you a delicious recipe that you can have while you're fasting. Made with water chestnut flour or commonly called as shingada flour, these farari puris go extremely well with the dahi. If you enjoyed today's video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, share and comment. Let's see how to make these delicious farari puri. Here I'm using 5 basic ingredients to make this farari puri. So in a mortar and pestle, I'm going to crush some cumin seeds, about half a teaspoon, and 1 green chili. You can also use black pepper instead of green chili. Just crush them together, it gives a nice flavor to our puri. Coarse mixture is ready. Let's take a big mixing bowl and now add 1 cup of shingada flour, 1 boiled potato, and I'm simply going to mash it with my hand. If you like, you know, you can also properly grate it and then add that. Since it's a farari puri, we are going to use black salt instead of regular one. And lastly, add the crushed cumin seeds and green chili. Mix everything really well. Adding water little by little, we are going to knead everything together to a medium soft dough. Since it's a farari puri, you know, the number of ingredients is really less. If you noticed, we used only 5, and that's the best part, and it comes out really good. The texture of the shingada flour or the water chestnut flour is a little bit thicker than your regular roti flour. I'm just greasing 1 teaspoon of oil. So while kneading, you know, make sure you don't add a lot of water. Here it looks great. Simply cover and let it rest. Next, we are just going to, you know, roll it into regular puri size and deep fry them. Make sure that the oil is hot enough and you fry these on a medium or medium high flame. So start kind of pressing them in oil on the sides like this so that they, you know, fluff up really well. Turn it around and again press it against the oil. And you'll notice that it fluffs up really well. Look at that. The color looks great, nice and golden brown. The puri is now well cooked inside out. Look at that. Let's take it out, and to drain excess oil, I'm gonna take it out on a tissue paper. Similarly, fry all the remaining puris. If you enjoyed today's recipe, please don't forget to share your valuable feedback. Have a great day.